guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day, that's when I walk, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father, God the Son. Well, 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 I want to tell them.
I sought the Lord. him out of all of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him. Thank you. righteous shall be desolate. The Lord redeemeth the soul of his servants, and none of them that trust in him shall be desolate. The Lord is my help. Leave me not
Amen. In that order, please. The word declares that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So just hold on to the morning time, to my cousins, Jamel, Vincent, love you. I'm here for you whenever you need me. We just want to encourage you to say, let God have his way.
Amen.
Couldn't seem to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind, searching for that peace, the peace I could not find. So then I kneel down.
When we look back over our lives and we can think of those moments when we laughed
those happy times that we shared along this way. That there was a woman named Pat Keith that shared those times with us. Thank you, oh God, that as she lived amongst us, oh God, you allowed us to laugh. And even now our hearts are heavy and tears are falling from our eyes, but yet, God, we tell you, thank you. Thank you, oh God, because we realize and know that when nobody else can wipe tears from our eyes, oh God, you are a God who can wipe all tears from our eyes. And right now, God, the Alexander family needs you just to wipe tears from their eyes today. Lift up, oh God, where they are broken down. Fix, oh God, those places in their heart where they are longing, oh God. For God, we know and we realize that there's nobody that can do it like you can. So God, in the midst of our sorrow, we tell you thank you. In the midst of tears falling from my eyes, we yet tell you thank you. That you allow her to live and to be a part of our lives. And oh God, even now when this time is over and those days come and this family longs just to have her near them, oh God, let them know that you are all that they need. That you can be there, that you are mother for the mother. That you can be a wife, that you can be everything that they need, oh God. Companionship, friendship, whatever they need, God. For God, we know if you did it yesterday, you can do it today. And if you can do it today, we know that you can take care of tomorrow. So God, we give it to you right now, asking you, oh God, to look down upon this family. And then God, just as you come and you call her home, we know we too one day got to go the same way. Help us, oh God, to get ready. For we don't know when and we don't know where, but we know one day we too must give up this busy walk of life. Help us, oh God, in this dying hour to know that we can make peace. And then God, we thank you for traveling mercy for those who have traveled from afar. Thank you, oh God, for bringing them safely here. And even after they prepare to go back home, we pray, God, that you would keep them and give them safe passage back home. We ask all these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray.
Old Testament reading will come from Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, verses 1 through 4. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. Yes. A time to be born and a time to die. Yes. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. Yes. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to mourn. A time to laugh and a time to dance. Our New Testament reading will come from Revelations, the 21st chapter, verses 1 through 4. And I saw a new heaven, a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there were no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all their tears from their eyes. And there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. The word of God for the people of God. May these words be a comfort to this bereaved family.
Thank you.
know that most of you are in funeral mode. But for those of us who testify, and in the midst of whatever you might be going through, that there is a God who is able to be saved in His arms.
Our loved ones and meet our friends and we'll hug them and we'll
embrace them and we'll hold their hand and then we'll tell them, I know what you're going through.
Yes,
and it comes from a place of sincerity. And it comes from people who really mean well, but when you really break that phrase down and know what that person is really going through, you really don't know what they're going through. You know, and it's easy to say, well, you know, I remember when I lost my, and whatever else you put at the end of it. And that was a situation that affected you in such a way, but you still don't know in this moment what somebody else is going through. And again, I'm not trying to cause you to rethink your sincerity, but I want you to understand that there are times when you might have had a situation similar to what I'm going through, but you don't know just what I'm really going through. Because what I'm going through in this moment might not necessarily be where you were when you were going through what you were going through. See, because there's a difference in going through something and having a God on your side than going through something and don't know who the Lord is. So for those of us who understand who the Lord is, so whatever we're going through, we recognize I might be broken, but I'm not destroyed. I might be broken in this moment, but I know that God is able to lift me up and he will take me to a place where I still might cry every now and then, but I lift up my head because I know who the Lord is. And I'm sharing this now because all too many times we want to be there for people and we want to help them come from out of the grief that they're in. But in the midst of their grief right there, you also have to think about when you were in that position. Because you just told them, you know what they were going through. And while you were telling them that, you also remember somebody said some things to you that even though they were telling you and you knew they were good for you, at that moment you really didn't want to hear it.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
You know, because when people are hugging you in the midst of your grief, in the midst of your sorrow, you feel the love. And you hear everything that they're saying to you, but in that moment, all you're thinking about in that moment is, what am I going through? And I know when I look at this Alexander family, that phrase has probably been said to you time and time again throughout this week. And it came from family, and it came from friends who meant it in the most sincerest of ways. But yet while they went home and got in their beds and drove in their cars, they thought about what they went through then. But you are still going through it right now. And what I'm trying to get you to understand that what you're feeling in this very moment is brokenness, is painful, is sorrowful. But I want to encourage you and let you know that you can be healed.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, oftentimes we catch hold to grief and we hold on to it and we don't want to let go of it. But you have to understand something. Grief, just like everything else you go through, is a process. And in the midst of the process, you got to know that all things around you are not necessarily going to be the way you want them to be, but you still got to hold on. You still got to keep trusting. You still got to keep looking to God. You still got to keep binding together, understanding that in this very moment, God is still able. God is still able. And when we look at the text here that we shared with you this afternoon, there's a point here that I want you to get. In this verse, David writes how God understands our feelings. See, I just told you all of us can say, I know it, but God truly understands. God understands our feelings and he helps us to bear the burden of sorrow. And what I want you to understand, there are people who don't believe in God. And I wonder how, when they go through what we are going through, how do they make it when they don't even have a God that they can take it to? Because think about where you are. Think about how you feel. Think about when you lost those that you love and when they are no longer there. Who could you turn to when everybody went home? Who could you turn to when nobody answered their telephone? Who could you turn to when you were texting folks and they were not responding to your text? Who could you turn to when nobody was in the house but you? You had nobody to go to but God. And in the midst of your sorrow, God told me, I'm here with you. I'm holding you. I'm letting you know that it's going to be all right.
Yeah. understand what you're going through.
Yes.
And when Jesus, think about Jesus, when he went to Lazarus' grave, he went there grieving with the sisters. He went there comforting those sisters. The Bible even says that Jesus wept.
Yes.
He wept in the midst of his weeping. But he already knew he was going to call Lazarus from the grave. But because he understood where they were, he let them know that it's all right to cry.
Yes,
in the midst of your grief.
Yes,
in the midst of your sorrow. In the midst of your pain, it's all right. But then guess what he shows us? He shows them that I'm experiencing all of these things with you, but I'm the one that can see you through.
Yes.
Through it all.
Yes.
So then as I prepare to take my seat, I want to speak directly to the Alexander family. And I want you to understand something. Each of us here today can think of a moment that we shared, and when I was talking to Jamila phone over there, I told her, I said, I don't know how to call her anything but Pat Key. And it was never from a place of disrespect, it was just that that's all we ever knew. And I would have been in trouble if somebody would have had to ask me what her real name was, because I would have argued them down that, well, if it ain't Pat, it's Patricia. Because I said, every time I said Pat Key, she turned around and said, what? But I want you to know that each of us in here today can think of a moment that we shared with your wife, your mother, your grandmother, whatever the kinship is, we can think of a moment just like you have, and because of that moment, there is something inside of us that's going to cause us to miss her. We'll miss her. We might not miss her the way you all are going to miss her, but we'll miss her. Because there's somebody who's not going to have that friend that they can call on the telephone and talk to. There's somebody who's not going to have that buddy that will ride by and be there with them. There's going to be somebody that won't have that cousin that they can talk about family times together. It's going to be that son that's going to want to call his mom and not be able to answer. But in the midst of your broken spirit, I want you to know that there is a God who can heal you. That's falling from your eyes. There's a God that wants you to know that in this very moment, all you got to do is lean and depend upon me. But guess what? We as your family, we as your friends, we're going to go home. Not because we don't care about you, but we're going home. And when we go home, you're going to be left there. And somebody said you're going to be there by yourself. But I beg the difference. I beg the difference. And the reason I beg the difference is because I know a man named Jesus. I know a man named Jesus that if you call early in the morning, he'll show up. I know a man named Jesus that if you call him late in the midnight hour, he will show up. I know a man named Jesus that when you're riding down the street by yourself and it looks like you don't know where you're going, he will show up. I know a man named Jesus, and all you got to do is say, Lord, have mercy on me right now, and he'll show up. I know a man named Jesus that will hold you when nobody else wants to hold you. I know a man named Jesus that will be right there in the midnight hour, early in the morning, falling that way, whatever it is. His name is
Jesus.
And he's the God. Broken heart.
Yes.
He's the God
yes.
of the broken spirit.
Yes.
And whatever you think that can't be fixed in your life, I want to let you know that Jesus can fix it for
yes.
you. I want you to know that he not only can fix it, but he'll put you at a point where you'll look back and realize and tell somebody, not only did it bring me through, but it kept me in the midst of what I was going through. So family, I know you feel broken.
Yes.
And I know it's difficult right now, but I just want to encourage you with that same phrase. You might be broken, but you're not destroyed.
Amen.
Eternal God, our Father, we thank you now. We thank you, O God, for your grace and your mercy. Thank you, O God, for seeing us through those moments that we need you. And right now, God, we need you right now. But God, in the midst of our sorrow, in the midst of our pain, we know that you are able to heal those who are broken. Repair broken spirits right now. Lift up bowed down heads. And as you lift our heads today, oh God, we come to tell you thank you for all that you're doing right now. We ask these blessings in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.